Good evening, everyone. How are you doing? Thank you so much for choosing to spend your Friday evening with us. I know there's a lot going on this weekend in Durango. Prom is tomorrow night at the high school, so stay off the roads, adults. But welcome. This is our final instrumental band and jazz band concert of the school year. We're really excited that we're close to the end of the school year, aren't we, guys? Yeah, they're so tired. They're like, yeah, whatever. The first piece you heard was a piece entitled Vanity Fair. I usually like to start most band concerts with marches, just to mix it up a little bit. That was a festive overture, a comedy overture, raised by Brant Carrick. So you can kind of hear, had kind of march-like qualities, but also had some nice lyricism in the middle. Next piece is a really special piece for us. We get to share the stage with one of our fantastic colleagues. It's an arrangement of a clarinet concertino by Von Baber. The colleague that I'm about to bring out has been on the faculty for a long time, way longer than I've been here and way longer than you guys have been here. Has had a tremendous impact and footprint, not only on Fort Lewis College, but on our community of Durango, our region, and also our state. Dr. Mark Walters has served in many capacities, including most recently, he's been doing a lot of work on our institution's upcoming HLC accreditation team. Teaches music ed classes, teaches blues, jazz, and rock, teaches woodwind, does band, you name it, he does it. And tonight you get to hear him in a little bit different role. You get to hear him as a clarinet soloist. So please welcome to the stage my friend and colleague, Dr. Mark Walters.
Thank you.
So I think one of the unique things and cool things about the WinBand medium is the fact that not only do we get to play cool older things, we get to play really neat new things. This is a new composition that actually was just premiered, I know the date and I don't want to give you misinformation, recently, like within the last 2 months, I believe. Give a little bit of background, you kind of saw in the program kind of how this piece came about. Last year ago, Mother's Day, John Wacker, who was the director of bands at Western State, was killed in a car accident on Mother's Day. He was a friend of mine from grad school. I knew him from the time we were at UNT together. Really great guy, great trumpet player, tremendous dad. He left behind two kids. One, I believe, is 13, and one's 15, a son that was just like him. It was kind of tragic, kind of sad. Was on his way to a gig right after graduation in May. It was raining here in Durango, and up by Fair Play, somebody crossed the center line and hit him head on. One of the cool things about music, I think, is, you know, not only do we get to play things that we like and things that are enjoyable, but a lot of times we get to play things that are special to us. And Alan Mills, who was the director of bands at Pueblo, every year does a composition and kind of tied in Andy Boyson into this, who's actually an Iowa guy. He actually wrote a piece for my Allstate band when I was in Iowa in 1996, I think. But wrote this for John. It's divided into two movements. The first one is kind of solemn. The second one is kind of Pied Piper-ish. You get to see kind of the program notes. Other thing that kind of happened to us recently that was very, very tragic, that touched, I know, a lot of us, Adam Burris, who is the brother of one of our current music students, Tom, was from Cortez and has spent a couple of years in Wyoming doing his associate's degree. And I was planning on enrolling this year in school in the fall, and was going to be a tuba major, audition, sounded great, super kid, had some bouts with, I believe it was leukemia. I had been feeling better, was planning on enrolling this fall, things took a turn for the worse, and he actually lost his battle in January. So I'd like to dedicate this to him and to John. We've got a chair in the back row for Adam. Hope you enjoy this piece.
Thank you. seniors were playing their last concert, and I want to make sure they have a chance to stand up and give them some recognition. On the front row here, Matt Lay. Matt's an art major and was pulling double duty. Didn't you just have your senior art exhibit like 2 hours ago? Yeah, so Matt took time out of his busy artistic schedule to come and play football with us tonight. So thanks, Matt. Back in the third row, Christina Demmert. Horn. Christina's an education major and is actually going back up to Seattle, right, to student teach? Yeah, so this will be her last concert, so we wish her the best of luck. On the back row, we have a couple of percussionists. One tall and one not as tall. let's go from short to biggest, how about that? Tyler Coley is in the back next to Kyle. And you may think he looks familiar because he's in like every single production that any play does anywhere in Durango. So if you've seen him before, that's probably where you've seen him. Kyle Harlbach next to him. Kyle's actually from Arizona, and he's going back down there in the fall to student teach, so we wish him the best, and we wish all of our seniors nothing but the best. So this last piece is a favorite of mine. I got to know it as a student, and I've gotten to conduct it a couple times, and every time I get to conduct it, I really kind of fall in love with it over and over again. It's a piece by Robert Jager, who is not the most well-known composer, but this really is kind of one of the staples of the band repertoire. It has some kind of funky meters, some kind of, I guess you can kind of say, tongue-in-cheek moments. I think there are times when I think he's almost sticking his tongue out of his mouth at the audience. But this is Robert Jager's Third Suite. Thank you.
Thank you.
We're going to take a short pause while we listen to Jeff.
Thank you. All right, thank you. My name is John O'Neill. I'm the director of the Fort Lewis College Jazz Ensemble here. And the first tune you heard is a piece called Up and Running by a trombonist named John Fedchuk. And you can hear it's very involved, very difficult, lots of lines going on. People don't line up, they line up. It's crazy and it's really neat. It's very, very different from a traditional swing band tune that you might hear. Very fun. So the next tune we're gonna play is a piece called St. Thomas. You might have heard of this. This is a Sonny Rollins tune. Sonny Rollins is a legendary tenor sax player, and he's really well known for this work. This is an arrangement by a gentleman named Mark Taylor. And it's a different style. It's more of that samba, not so much swing, but more of a samba, fast Latin type of feel. It's going to feature a lot of soloists. This is St. Thomas, arranged by Mark Taylor.
Thank you.
All right. This is a fun little piece to play. So solos you heard there, Mark West on trumpet, Bryce Daly on trombone, Kelly Emery on trumpet, and Glenn Tinnen on trombone. So how about another hand for them? All right, the next one's a fun one. This is a piece originally by another legendary musician named Horace Silver, arranged by a gentleman, a trumpet player named John LaBarbera. John LaBarbera is a big name for jazz. He played and arranged for groups like Glenn Miller Orchestra, Woody Herman's Big Band, countless others, lots of them. And actually, we had the pleasure of playing with his brother, Joe LaBarbera, with the Jazz Festival back in March, which was a lot of fun. So this is his arrangement of the Horace Silver tune, Filthy McNasty. Thank you. Thank you. We've got one more tune for you. Before we play this, I want to thank you all for coming tonight. I also want to say this has been a crazy semester for us with the jazz festival, school things, performance things, whatever. And these students have worked really hard on all of this music, and we've played a ton of music this year. So before we play this last tune, I do want to make sure I thank them for all their hard work and putting up with me and everything. So how about a hand for them? Okay, so the last tune we're going to play is a fun kind of rock, funk type of tune. It's by a guy named Bob Mincer. It's going to feature several soloists also, Amos Brown on Barry Sax, John Patton on trumpet, Dane Fogdahl on tenor sax, and Andrew Pearson on drums. So thank you again for coming tonight. This is Funk City Ola.